Hello all. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Double E Lectures. I am Dr. Saurav Mani Tripathi and the topic of this short lecture is Direct Current Machines Classifications. As we have already learned that the function of the magnetic field system in a DC machine is to produce the effective and uniform main field flux within which the armature rotates. In this short lecture, I will let you know about the classification of DC machines based on the methods of field winding excitations. So have a look on the methods of field winding excitation in DC machines. Generally, we have four common methods to excite the field winding of DC machines. These are, number one, separate excitation, in which the field winding is connected to an independent DC source. Number two, shunt excitation, in which the field winding is connected in parallel to the armature winding. Number three, series excitation, in which the field winding is connected in series to the armature winding. And number four, compound, which actually comprises a combination of both the shunt and series field excitations. So, based on the methods to excite the field winding, the DC machines can broadly be classified into separately excited DC machine, shunt excited DC machine, series excited DC machine, and compound DC machine. We will now discuss this classification of DC machines one by one. So the first one is separately excited DC machine. This is the representation of a separately excited DC machine, wherein the field winding is represented by a coil and the armature by a circle. Moreover, two small black rectangles touching the circle represent the brushes on the commutator. Besides, the field winding is shown in perpendicular to brush axis due to the fact that in DC machines, the brush positioning is made in quadrature to the axis of magnetic field. As already stated, in separately excited DC machines, the field winding is connected to an independent DC source such as battery. This means the field and armature circuits are independent to each other. In addition, it is worth mentioning that the field winding of a separately excited DC machine comprises many turns of thin wire. Actually, many turns implies larger length of wire, and thin wire implies a small cross-sectional area. Thus, we have a high resistance of the field winding. Next one is shunt excited DC machine. This is the representation of a shunt excited DC machine, wherein you may easily notice that the field winding is connected in parallel to the armature winding. Furthermore, it is worth notable that, like separately excited DC machine, the field winding in a shunt excited DC machine also comprises many turns of thin wire, thus having high resistance. While shunt excited DC machine is operating in generating mode, the generated voltage across the armature terminals is applied to the field winding. In contrast, while it is operating in motoring mode, both the field winding and armature winding are connected across the common DC supply. On the other hand, in a series excited DC machine, as represented now on your screen, you may easily notice that the field winding is connected in series to the armature winding. Therefore, in a series excited DC machine, the field winding and armature carry the same current. That's why, unlike separately excited and shunt excited DC machines, a low resistance in series field winding would be a requisite. For this reason, the field winding of a series excited DC machine comprises only a few turns of thick wire. Next one is compound DC machine. As you may see in a typical representation of a compound DC machine illustrated on your screen now, a combination of both the shunt and series field excitations are provided. However, in a compound DC machine, the shunt field is substantially stronger than the series field. Notice that in this typical arrangement of field winding connections, the shunt field winding is in parallel with the armature alone. Actually, with this sort of field winding arrangement, the machine is called short shunt compound DC machine. On the other hand, have a look on another typical representation of compound DC machine, wherein you may easily notice that the shunt field winding is in parallel to both armature winding and series field winding. Actually, with this sort of field winding arrangement, the machine is called long shunt compound DC machine. Besides these, the compound DC machines can further be subclassified into cumulative compound and differential compound DC machines. In order to understand the difference between these two, let us first consider that these compound DC machines are operating in generating mode. Now, for both the short shunt and long shunt arrangements, the direction of the currents in series field windings of compound DC generator are as indicated by the red arrows. On the other hand, the directions of the currents in shunt field windings of compound DC generator are as indicated by the blue arrows. In short shunt compound DC generator, with typical field winding connections as depicted in first figure, it can easily be observed that the direction of the current in series field winding is identical to that in shunt field winding. Consequently, the series field strengthens the shunt field, and therefore, such a generator is said to be cumulative compound DC generator. On the other hand, in long shunt compound DC generator with typical field winding connections as depicted in second figure, it can easily be observed that the direction of the current in series field winding is opposite to that in shunt field winding. Consequently, the series field weakens the shunt field, and therefore, such a generator is said to be differential compound DC generator. Now consider that these compound DC machines are operating in motoring mode. In short shunt compound DC motor, with typical field winding connections as depicted in first figure, it can easily be observed that the direction of the current in series field winding is opposite to that in shunt field winding. Consequently, the series field weakens the shunt field, and therefore, such a motor is said to be differential compound DC motor. On the other hand, in long shunt compound DC motor, with typical field winding connections as depicted in second figure, it can easily be observed that the direction of the current in series field winding is identical to that in shunt field winding. Consequently, the series field strengthens the shunt field, and therefore, such a motor is said to be cumulative compound DC motor. So, this is all about the classification of the DC machines based on the methods of field winding excitation. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.